So what did you make of the performance on Saturday?
I thought it was very good. I felt the first half especially, you know, we really were disciplined in our defensive duties, and going forward I thought we attacked with great numbers and especially little Chungy as well getting in there, and with three or four half chances, and disappointed really not to be 1-0 up. So the first half was a great response. I think they changed it obviously, which is credit to us. They changed it and brought in a couple of very, very good players, and Campbell and Noon, which gave them a little lift going forward. End of the day, a mistake knocked us out of the cup, but the last 25 minutes I thought we threw everything at it. Great commitment from the lads, and very unlucky not to take something from the game.
Were you pleased with how they responded to the Reading result?
I was very pleased. You know, we worked very hard last week, and you know, listen, we've got a good bunch of lads here who just from time to time lack concentration. You know, I've never doubted their ability going forward, and defensively as a team we can always get better. But, you know, that lack of concentration let us down in a few occasions this season. So we just need to make sure that, you know, every game we're on it from the beginning. And if we can stay in the game tomorrow night for any length of time, then I do believe we'll grow in confidence.
You made some changes with Craig Davis playing. How were your thoughts on his?
I thought he was terrific. I thought he was great against Cardiff, you know, Premiership side. I thought he led the line very well. Worked very hard for the team, you know. Put his body in the line, and I was really happy for him. You know, he needs a run of games, Craig. He really just needs to play games. He's never, unfortunately, had a run of games at the football club, whether it be last year, the lack of people's performances in his position, or this year through injury. He just needs to, you know, every confidence, he just needs to play games. And when he turns out four or five games in a row, I think he'll be a lot better for him.
It's just a case really of him, I suppose, getting those games and showing the fans what he can do, because he has scored at this level before.
Oh, he has scored at this level. I think last season he did prove to himself, you know, he was capable of scoring goals for the football club. This season's been a stop-start season for him. I think he's carried a few injuries. It's not helped him. It's just unlucky. And we've kind of had that kind of season, you know, with one or two key injuries for us. But, you know, the key to having staying fit and getting games.
And you got tomorrow night another away game against QPR, another side who would... Premier League last year, but now
QPR games going to be a difficult game for us, you know, down at Loftus Road, but it gives us an opportunity to put ourselves up against them, up against our opposition number, and make sure that we compete and make sure we give it everything we've got, you know. And I strongly believe if we can compete as a team and concentrate for the first 25 minutes then go into the game. You know, it was a very close game at the Reebok, and I'm wondering why we didn't take anything from that game. Because we didn't take our chances, so hopefully when the chances come along tomorrow night, we can take them.
Is it also going to be key to take your chances, because they've got arguably the most deadly striker in the division in Charlie Austin?
Yeah, they've got a couple of strikers there. You know, AJ is a striker, capable, very capable. Zamora is very capable. Cranshaw is very capable, you know. But as you say, in Charlie Austin, you know, he does score goals, and we've done a lot of work on him today, and the video work on him, and watching his runs and making sure his movements, you know, with his quick movement, you know, where he pulls off at the back post. We've identified that, and we make sure everything was looked at very thoroughly, so we know exactly what he's going to do, we exactly know how QPR is going to play, and it's up to us to try and stay, keep our concentration levels high, make sure we put ourselves up against our opposition number, and make sure we do the job that's required.
See a player you've specifically focused on then?
He's one of them. You know, Cranshaw is another player that's got great quality, but he is one of the players that's obviously his goal scoring record, he's terrific, you know. It is what it is. QPR, you know, they're up the top of the division because of the Charlie Austins of this world. It's no different. It's the same as Burnley. They're up the top of there because of the Danny Ings, and Leicester up the top of them because of one or two goal scorers up there. So there's no secret to anybody's success. If you can get your goal scorers firing, you're going to be up the top of the league.
Any team news ahead of the game?
Everything's good. Everybody's fine. Mark Davis comes back into the squad, rested from Saturday's match. Hopefully we'll have a bit of good news with Djukovic's signing, but that's just not quite done yet with the last bits of paper up with that, but hopefully that'll be good as well.
So if you do bring him in, he'll be able to play?
Hopefully.
How close is that then?
Yeah, it's very close. It's just paperwork needs to be done, really. Now that it's agreed over the phone, it just needs to be done paperwork, but that can sometimes take a little bit longer than we all want it to.
Do you think Djukovic could be your last arrival of the window?
No, I don't. I expect to sign on the window maybe, but I expect to sign another couple of players to help the defensive players, because they've, since just all over Christmas, you know, they've churned out games after games. So, you know, we've been asking a lot of them. So I think we need a little bit of help in that department, and hopefully we'll get that.
Have you made inquiries to fill those positions?
Yeah, a couple of positions have been inquired. You know, I don't just make random phone calls. We've identified the players we would like to sign. And we're just, it's a waiting game right now to see if they're going to let them go in the Premiership and to see if we can get them in loan.
And just finally, then these two quite long away trips, these Ipswich and QPR, how important is it to get something out of one of them?
Well, you know, you can prepare yourself best as possible and you make sure you're organised again into the games, you're making sure you pick the correct teams, and then if we do that and get the rest and recovery correct, then I don't see why we can't take points out of these two games. It's a very tight division, very close division, and I'm sure, you know, we on the day, you know, anything can happen, but we'll certainly be down there with making sure we compete and making sure we're in a good, we're in the game.